Hello everyone, welcome to the channel today. So today we have Ms. Priyanka Pai, who has cleared her UGC NET exam in the subject of law in December 2019. So aaj hum inse baat karne wale hain aur janenge ki inhone kaise taiyari kari hai. So hello Priyanka, welcome to our channel.
Thank you, sir.
So first of all, congratulations Priyanka. Law, which is considered to be one of the toughest NET exams, you have cleared your NET. So, I hope कि आज जो भी हम बात करने वाले हैं आपकी strategies के बारे में और जो भी आपने तैयारियां करी हैं उसके बारे में, तो उससे काफी help होने वाली है हमारे students को. So, सबसे पहले मैं आपसे एक पहला question ये पूछना चाहूंगा कि what has been your educational qualifications and आपने कौन से courses pursue किए हैं before clearing your UGC NET exam? Please इसके बारे में कुछ हमें बताइए.
सर, मैं बॉम्बे में पली बड़ी हूँ. I've lived here all my life. तो मेरा स्कूलिंग यहीं पे हुआ था एंड आफ्टर द एंड ऑफ माय क्लास 12 आई डिसाइडेड आई वांट टू परस्यू लॉ. तो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ माय क्लास 12 मार्क्स मुझे एडमिशन मिला गवर्नमेंट लॉ कॉलेज मुंबई में. वहां से मैंने 5 साल का LLB कोर्स किया है और व्हेन आई वाज स्टडिंग लॉ उसके साथ ही आई परस्यूड माय कंपनी सेक्रेटरी डिग्री टू. तो वो तीनों लेवल मैंने फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में क्लियर किया. So by the end of my second year at the age of 19, I was a company secretary. After that, I started doing my internships. I did my articleship for legal internships. Or in my final year of law, that is in my fifth year, 2017-18, mere college se maine ek postgraduate diploma in securities law kiya and I topped my batch in that too. So yes, I have been academically inclined all my life and I enjoy studying.
So I can see that your lawyer. Academic record has been tremendous. So it would not have been much difficulty for you to clear UGC NET exam because aapko itna rich experience in terms of being a company secretary as well and then topping your batch. So I think I must say that's very inspiring for the lot of upcoming students as well. So congratulations once
Thank
again.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, my Thank next you. Question
so
is that
I liked enjoy. Sorry.
Yeah, please.
No, I enjoyed studying law. So even during. Now my preparation, I could recollect whatever I had studied through my 5 years. So the conceptual clarity which mein tha. So I didn't find it that difficult to study all over again. So it was sort of like a revision.
Okay, wonderful. Priyanka, when did you realize that now you should start your preparations for UGC NET? What was the time? Can you give us a brief about this?
मैंने एग्जाम फॉर्म तो फिल किया था सितंबर अक्टूबर में बिकॉज माय फ्रेंड टोल्ड मी दैट दिस इज अ प्रीटी गुड एग्जाम टू अपीयर फॉर. और आई हैव आल्सो बीन प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर बैंक एग्जाम्स द लीगल फील्ड लीगल स्ट्रीम ऑफ बैंक एग्जाम्स एंड आई थॉट दैट दिस एग्जाम माइट बी अ गुड एक्सपीरियंस. इट विल हेल्प इट विल गिव मी सम इनसाइट इनटू हाउ क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क्ड फॉर गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स स्पेशली पर्टेनिंग टू लीगल क्वेश्चंस. तो उसकी वजह से आई अप्लाइड फॉर दिस नेट एग्जाम और मेरा एक्चुअल मैंने लॉ का पढ़ा है ना. I started just a fortnight before the exam, 15-20 days before the exam. So mid-November, I got my old textbooks out from inside wherever in the cupboard I had kept it. And I used the same textbooks that I had studied as part of my five-year course. The name is Jhabwala because Bombay University, that's my university. वही टेक्सटबुक प्रिस्क्राइब करता है. इट्स अ फेमस टेक्सटबुक कॉल्ड Jhabwala. सो आई स्टडीड ओनली फ्रॉम देयर फॉर लॉ. And plus, I also saw a couple of videos on Unacademy pertaining to UGC NET Law. And I started making my own notes. So even those came in handy.
Okay, wonderful. So I think that even though you have started your preparations very late in terms of November, because aapka exam December mein tha, but maybe since you come from a very good background in terms of academics, so isliye aapke jo concepts the, wo kaafi achhe the and that must have helped you. Is that so?
Yes, sir. That's my understanding too. Also, because I was preparing for bank exams, for paper one, my reading comprehension, maths and reasoning, it was quite easy for me. I had a glance into the old last year papers and I found them that, okay, they are quite easy, they are doable. I do not have to put in much effort for them. But yes, there were subjects like research, teaching and Indian logic. These are things I've never come across before. So for that, I had subscribed to your course and I watched all your videos. So they helped me a lot.
Oh, wonderful. Can you specifically tell us that what were the materials or what were the sources that you have used for paper one and then for paper two? Taki jo hamare students hain, jo prepare karne wale hain for the upcoming exam, unko bhi kuch idea lag jaye. Because there are a lot of students who have queries ki there are a lot of materials available online and at several other places. But unhe pata nahi hota ki which are of good quality and where to focus on. To thoda sa iske bare mein please bataiye.
Zarur sir. मैंने पेपर वन के लिए आपका ही पूरा वो पैकेज लिया था एंड आई वॉच्ड ऑल योर वीडियोस एंड आई स्टडी लाइक दिस आई स्टडी एवरीथिंग ट्वाइस तो एक बार मैं वीडियो देखती हूँ छोटे मोटे ऐसे नोट्स लिखती हूँ एंड देन आई अगेन सी द वीडियोस एंड आई गो थ्रू माय नोट्स अगेन टू एंश्योर दैट इन केस आई हैव मिस्ड आउट ऑन एनीथिंग आई कैन राइट सम मोर to elaborate upon it. So that's how I studied for paper one. I watched your entire set of videos twice. And plus my reasoning, maths and logic was quite okay because I've been preparing for other bank exams, like I said, and the level of NET is considerably lower, at least for these subjects, as opposed to government bank exams. So that was quite easy for me. Now coming to paper two. Paper two, initially it was a little overwhelming because I only had 15 days and there was a lot to study. And especially when I had seen past year paper pattern, I realized that they ask everything under the sun when it comes to law. They ask case laws, they ask sections, they ask definitions, they ask jurisprudence. You have to know conceptually and you also need to do a lot of rote learning. So what I did was I just took out my old textbooks, whatever I had studied through law school, and started reading the entire textbook like a novel and made notes of important sections. Also, at the same time, to get a better understanding, because I believe that I'm a visual learner, I started seeing Unacademy videos on net law. Okay. So whatever I read, it was sort of like a revision to see it on video too. That helped. And plus, my notes were also running along. So that's how I prepared. So even though I had less time, I could clear it because I knew exactly what needed to be done in the limited time that I had.
Yeah, so I think that's wonderful. One more thing, Priyanka, since hume pata hai ki you were working for a law firm, so kitna difficult tha aapke liye roj time nikalna and how did you manage the time? Please iske bare mein thoda sa batai, because bahut sare aise students hain who are either working in somewhere or they are actually pursuing their law course. So काफी difficult हो जाता है दोनों चीजों को मैनेज करना. So what was your daily routine and कितने घंटे आप डेली देते थे during your preparation time?
जी सर. So I live in Bombay and Bombay mein a lot of time goes in commuting. So what I used to do was in the train also I would take my book or I would just keep seeing videos on Unacademy in through my phone. So that way, because I knew I had limited time and working in a law firm, the hours get crazy. I had to reach office at 9 and there were days when I would leave at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. So keeping all that in mind, I try to make the best possible use of whatever, optimum use of whatever time I had. So jahan pe bhi time milta tha, I would start studying. So I would always ensure that with me, a legal textbook, or I would at least have my phone on me so that I could see videos and it would be like a revision. Plus, thankfully, weekends were not working. So Saturday, Sunday, properly I studied like how I used to study for my college exams. So I would wake up early in the morning and catch up on whatever I missed out or I could have done better during the week. So Saturday, Sunday, I put in a lot of hours. At least the last two, three Saturday, Sundays, I would have studied for roughly 14 hours a day. I know it sounds like a lot, but I didn't want this exam. I wanted to clear it in my first attempt. And whatever I do, I thought, yeah, I'll give it my best. So I put in a lot of effort. And I think that's something everyone should do.
So I think so maybe aapne ye strategy apnai of using this time gaps or what we call interstices. I think that has paid you a lot. And that is the reason why you have cleared your UGC NET exam in your first attempt, even when you were working at a law firm. So many times it becomes very crazy that aapke paas job ka bhi kaafi pressure and then aapko syllabus bhi complete karna. So I'm sure that it has been it must be very tiresome, but I think that paid off.
Yes, sir, definitely. So that was my motive throughout. So even when I was studying in college, I would tell myself, okay, I just have to study for 10 days and I'm going to reap the benefits of these 10 days of intense work through my life. So that should be your motivation. One should not get bogged down by thinking, okay, 10 din mujhe 14 ghanta padhai karna hai. Wo 14 ghanta padhai karne ka natija aage jaake bahut kaam aane wala hai aapko. So one must look into it.
जो आपने ना पढ़े और आपको डिफिकल्टी आ रही हो या फिर पेपर टू में एंड हाउ डिड यू रिजॉल्व इट
ओके सर पेपर वन टू बी कम्प्लीटली ऑनेस्ट आई गॉट अ लिटिल कंफ्यूज्ड विद दैट इंडियन लॉजिक that's why I saw your video. वो chapter का मैंने video चार बार देखा, so that way I could understand. Plus, I also tried getting questions online, and I solved those also. तो उस वो chapter में जो मुझे पता था कि थोड़ा मुश्किल होने वाला है, I put in extra effort for that. Okay, that was for paper one. Other than Indian logic, I did not find other chapters that taxing or tiring, because I believe that this was a pretty general paper. Now, there are subjects like research aptitude, and you have questions like ethics. Now, if you are any sane, rational person, you should know what is, you should know where to draw the line between right and wrong. So one does not need to put extra emphasis on things like that. But when there are course, when there are subjects like, say, your Indian logic, then pramanas and other things, which you don't get to see in your general life, I think you should target to ace those well, because you know for a fact that usme se question aane wale hai ye. So that was how I worked. That was a difficult area that I faced for paper one. Coming to paper two, I realized that I have less time and I also need to rote learn a lot of things, especially sections. Now, remembering sections becomes a task. So what I did was I broke down the portion into small, small parts. So for example, I do not want to get bogged down ki I have to study a lot. I have to study a whole lot of sections. So what I did was every day I would take a particular act and study 10 or 12 important sections, whatever I deemed was important, or usme se case laws I would write down, theek hai? And next day, when I would take another act and study, I would read yesterday's notes that I made. So that way it got fit, it was framed in my mind. So I knew for a, I knew properly that these are the important sections and important case laws, and I could remember it better. So I made little notes, did not get bogged down by the sheer volume, and studied every day consistently. So that is how I studied for law section, for law paper two.
I think the best part is to identify that what are the areas where you need to focus. Jaise aapko pata tha ki Indian logic is the thing that you have not studied, and maybe that is the time where you actually need to put in effort. Also, I would like to tell you that since Indian logic is a new topic which has been introduced from June 2019 only, so this is just the second attempt which you have given. So obviously, jo questions hai, wo nye topic se aa rahe hain, nye nye concepts se aa rahe hain. So it is important that we actually clarify that. And I think that is what you have done. Yes. You have focused on these areas, and I think that is superb. My next question to you is that many a times we get to know that a student, that how useful has been the past year's paper. So had you referred to past year's papers, aur unse kitni zyada aapko madad mili? Matlab kitne questions aaye the? Were they getting repeated from past years or what? Please iske bare mein thoda hame bataiye.
Okay, zarur sir. So for paper one, I just referred to June 2019 and the June 2018 papers. Just glanced through them and I saw your course material, so I knew I was in good hands. So I did not have to worry about paper one. For paper two, what I did was I saw only three or four past question papers, and I realized that, okay, they ask everything possible. So I just read three or four papers and started making, started understanding the sort of questions that, okay, they need conceptual understanding, they need rote learning, and tried to focus my studies to address all of it. Yes, I did read three or four past question papers.
So I think that getting to read these past papers, se aapko thoda idea mil gaya hoga ki kaun kaun se areas pe focus karna hai. So I think that that was useful.
Yes, sir. Yeah. I'm sorry to cut you short, but I started my prep by seeing the past papers because I wanted to know what exactly I was dealing with. Mujhe wo in moment ke liye nahi chhodna tha, because then I would get nervous or frightened ki, okay, you know, I could have studied this aspect as well. No. So I started by seeing the paper and realizing how to tackle these exams properly. So if I could give anyone any advice about how to start studying for NET, it would be first read the paper, know exactly what sort of questions they ask and how to address it.
Yeah, I think that is the right strategy. कि जब आपको पता होता है कि पेपर का लेवल क्या है, किस टाइप के क्वेश्चंस आ रहे हैं, तो आपको ये पता चल जाता है कि आपको कैसे प्रिपरेशंस करनी है, बिकॉज सबसे ज्यादा तो हमें ही पता होता है कि हमें क्या चीज नहीं आती है. तो आई थिंक दैट वाज द राइट थिंग टू डू. वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन प्रियंका, व्हाट आर योर प्लान्स फॉर फ्यूचर? सो डू यू एक्चुअली वॉन्ट टू स्टे इन योर कॉर्पोरेट जॉब, और डू यू वॉन्ट टू गेट इन टू टीचिंग और इन टू पीएचडी? व्हाट आर योर प्लान्स?
ओके सर, for now I would like to stick to whatever I'm doing. I'm very happy with my job, and I'm not saying this because my boss will be watching, but I'm really genuinely happy doing corporate law. But then after a couple of years, if I feel like moving to a relatively relaxed job, or if it becomes a corporate law becomes a little too taxing, I might consider making a move to academia, and I'm sure the NET certificate will come in handy then. But in the immediate near future, say the next 5-10 years, I don't think I want to take up teaching.
So I think the best thing is that you love your job. Yeah.
Yes, sir. I do.
I think since you love your job, so it's better that अभी आप उसमें experience लें, you enrich yourself much more thing, and when you want to ship it, this particular definitely this NET certificate would certainly be helpful. So I think
And I would like to teach also in a very particular niche area. So I would like to specialize first in it, get the requisite knowledge and experience, and then probably start teaching, say, a corporate law or a securities law in any law college through the country. So yes, sir, that's my plan for now.
I think that's a wonderful approach also. कि एक बार पहले खुद अच्छे से एक्सपीरियंस कर लो, चीजों को एनरिच कर लो, एंड देन यू गो इन अ प्रॉपर एरिया. सो आई थिंक दैट जो हमारे आज इंटरव्यू रहा है विल बी वेरी हेल्पफुल टू ऑल द अपकमिंग स्टूडेंट्स जो जून 2020 का अटेम्प्ट देने वाले हैं. एंड थैंक यू सो मच प्रियंका फॉर फाइंडिंग योर टाइम एंड जॉइनिंग अस फॉर दिस वंडरफुल इंटरव्यू सेशन. सो आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू ऑन आवर बिहाफ. थैंक यू सो मच.
Thank you, sir. It was a great experience talking to you. Thank you so much. Prianka, and especially for your classes, they definitely helped. Especially the Indian logic and research aptitude. These are things that as a law student, you don't get to encounter or even when you're practicing. So I think they will definitely help anyone who does not have experience in this field.
Okay. Thank you, Prianka. Prianka, do you have any other questions? Kuch aap aur puchna chahenge?
No, sir, nothing other. No, sir, nothing.
Okay, okay. So thank you, Prianka. That was all for the interview.
Thank you so much, sir. It was great talking to you.
Okay. Thank you, Prianka. Thank you. Okay. Bye-bye. Take care. All the very best for your future.
Thank you so much, sir.
Bye. Okay. Bye-bye.